And our guest is Cassie King. She's from Direct Action Everywhere. And you should know that Direct Action Everywhere is one of those groups, animal rights groups, that really makes a lot of noise. And you know, I think anyone who's representing any kind of cause they believe in knows that you've got to make noise to bring attention to your cause. Hi, Cassie.
Hi, Mark. Thank you so much for having me on.
So let's talk a little bit about what Direct Action Everywhere is, and then let's talk about the specific controversy, or one of them anyway, involving Jeff Bezos and Whole Foods.
Sure. Well, Direct Action Everywhere is an international network of activists, just like myself, who have decided that we have this voice, we have this power to speak up for animals. And by tapping into the network, we can do amazing things. So one thing we do that's very unique and at the heart of the controversy is something called Open Rescue, which is going into the places where we know animals are being abused, like factory farms and slaughterhouses, documenting the conditions we find, and rescuing sick or dying animals, bringing them to care and story of the world with no masks and showing our faces publicly. And that does invite a lot of controversy, but it, at the end of the day, invites a conversation where I think it allows people to agree that an animal who is sick or dying in front of you, whether they're in a hot car, panting, or inside a factory farm, deserves the right to be rescued.
I guess now would be a time to say, first of all, the Skype, I know, fades in and out, everybody. We'll do our best to try to get Cassie. We still can hear you perfectly well, Cassie. I guess one of the things that's important to note is that, you know, seeing the conditions inside these factory farms and in these situations that involve animal cruelty can be extremely compelling, to the point that people can change their view of a certain business. You know, you may have a sense in your mind of this is organic farming, or this is they're cage free. You hear all these terms, but I know you guys go into these situations to expose the fact that, hey, this is horrifying what's going on here.
Absolutely, and that's one of the reasons that we seek out the places that we know are using the most humane marketing and making the proudest claims about their treatment of animals, to see how that actually holds up in reality. And what we find time and time again is that places like Whole Foods, which say they supply from no farms, caging or crating animals, in fact, are not only continuing to keep animals inside of cages, but they're allowing them to starve to death. They're allowing them to cannibalize. They're leaving them with wounds and just gross negligence that is causing systemic torture and death of these animals. And people are shocked to find that out, because I think the thing that's less controversial is that no one wants that to happen. And that's why people are willing to pay more money for what they believe is actually helping animals.
And this is why sort of the marketing of a more, quote, humane animal experience is so very effective, and why your group is effective in drawing attention to the fact that even though it claims to be more humane and maybe advertises more humane, it is anything but, because the process by definition just has no humanity as part of it. And you can go through the various areas of animal husbandry or exploitation, and I use it sort of synonymously in a way, because it is truly disturbing. I mean, disturbing understates it. So you guys do this controversial stuff. Tell everybody, again, Open Rescue is when you go into these places and you literally rescue one or two of these animals. The idea is just to bring attention. It's not like you're going in and grabbing all these animals out of this farm.
Correct. The idea is to get this conversation started where people can see what's actually happening, make more informed decisions. And really, we want to push the system, not just these individuals, but we want the legal and the legislative and political system to confront the question, should animals be treated this way? And time and time again, especially in California, we've seen our government respond to that question and affirm the rights of animals. We just had a major victory with the fur ban in California last year. And we've had specific laws like the actual Right to Rescue Act, that's actually what it was called, about animals inside of hot cars and giving any ordinary person the right to break a window, to commit this smaller crime in order to prevent a greater harm and to save that animal's life. And so when we put these questions in front of our government, in front of the industry, I think we force a conversation where people have to admit that there is one thing that's not controversial, and that's that we don't want these animals to suffer. We just need to extend that group of animals to see that they're starving, they're overheating, they're struggling to walk and to breathe inside ammonia-filled, filthy industrial sheds in a systemic fashion, and it's just hidden from public view.
So well said, and you're right. People almost to a person, I mean, I suppose there's some exceptions, but have such great hearts, you know, both in this country and around the world. And when they see what's happening, they have trouble supporting it. And I think that you're right. And I think you're right to push to point to victories, because those are some of the victories that have come from this attention that you've brought. Okay, now to this particularly controversial, I mean, it's funny, we're focusing on one, but you've done a lot. Direct Action Network does a lot of controversial stuff. But let's talk about the Whole Foods and Jeff Bezos protest for a second.
Sure. Well, I've already mentioned Whole Foods because it's a battle that continues to escalate, not because we'd be unwilling to sit down to the table and just have a conversation, but because Whole Foods is relentlessly unwilling to actually converse, and instead has driven it to the level of filing a statewide lawsuit to ban us from Whole Foods stores. They have denied what things we've found inside their farms anytime they've addressed the media, continue to double down on claims that they do not allow animals in cages, that they do not agree with the footage DXC is exposing. And it's been years now, since 2013, that DXC has been investigating Whole Foods and Amazon suppliers. And while at first their response was to ignore us in presumably the hopes that we would go away, what's happened since Whole Foods was acquired by Amazon in recent years is that they've turned to a new tactic, which is to try to shut us down through litigation, through this lawsuit. And, you know, in response to that, we have not been shut down. We have not gone away. We see the fact that they're repressing us as proof that we have some real threat here that needs to come out, that needs to be aired. And so we've had activists actually confront Whole Foods CEO John Mackey, Amazon CEO, richest person on the planet, Jeff Bezos, and get right up on stage and try to talk to them. I don't know if you think that's controversial. I'd love to hear what you think Jeff Bezos should be doing about criminal animal cruelty being exposed in his farms, because he has more power, more ability, and I think with that ability, more obligation than anyone to do something about the crisis that we're in right now that's affecting human and non-human animals globally.
And well, to the point about Jeff Bezos and Whole Foods, it also seems as though they represent themselves sort of to the woke generation, to the moneyed woke generation as well. And so to that extent, I mean, if you want to be all woke about it, you've got to be aware of the fact that there is all of this stuff going on, and you guys really drew back the curtain on this. And so this attention that you've now drawn toward Bezos and Whole Foods has come back to you in the form of the lawsuit. Has anyone been prosecuted as a result of, you know, you showed up at a Whole Foods store? I mean, I know you linked arms and you blocked, they would say, I guess, block people from coming through. I mean, you were trying to create attention and disturbance, but to be fair, I mean, that's a kind of controversial thing to do.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, the action that you're referencing happened at a Whole Foods in San Francisco. And in these more progressive cities, we've actually seen a lot of leniency, and not only that, but support. And it's in the bigger farm counties like Sonoma County where we have seen the opposite and seen the government take the side of Big Ag and support them in trying to repress us. So I myself am facing 8 felony charges in Sonoma County for going to Whole Foods and Amazon supplying farms for holding a flower, holding up a peace sign, and talking about what I'm seeing on live stream and showing the world what's happening. And in cases where we found sick animals, trying to help them, trying to give them food and water and get them to care.
This is a critical thing that you're saying. I don't mean to interrupt, but this is a critical thing you're saying, because this is the tactic that's been most aggressive by industry. And that is to bring charges of felony to you and many other activists who are there, as you say, and you're committed, DXC, as I know, to nonviolent situations always, even in the face of violence. You're committed. I know it's sort of in your doctrine to be nonviolent. I'm not trying to rep particularly for you. I'm just suggesting that everything I've read really makes that sort of a doctrinal principle, you know, the nonviolence. And yet these felony accusations and these legal challenges that have involved felonies, that's a serious thing.
It is, and you're right that we've had over 120 people now arrested on multiple felony charges in Sonoma County alone. And these are people who were completely nonviolent actions where grandmothers were present, young children were present, and we made it very clear our intentions were to help the animals. And yet the response is dozens of police in riot gear and these felony charges and $20,000 bail and just such an amped up situation that makes it very clear these prosecutions, they really are politically motivated. And then when we go to other politicians, we go to other legislatures like San Francisco and Berkeley, we've seen a huge difference. And in fact, Berkeley just passed, just in December, a resolution to say, we're condemning the prosecution of these activists in Sonoma County, and we support the right to rescue animals who are suffering and in need of help. And so to go to the exact opposite extreme, they're actually stepping in and saying that when citizens take action that is both, you know, morally justified and legally justified, because we do have a legal argument in California law to help these animals, that it's wrong to prosecute those people instead of doing anything about the criminal animal cruelty that's being exposed.
Cassie King, good luck to you. DX Everywhere is how you can reach them on Twitter, at DX Everywhere. It's direct action everywhere. And Cassie, good luck. I should say that, you know, industry would tell you, hey, look, they're getting in the way of our ability to do business. So I don't want to not at all represent what they're saying. But again, that's about money. And that's why there's so much pushback. You're getting in the way of revenue. But anyway, Cassie King, thank you. I hope we talk again.
Thank you, too.